Thanks for staying with us, ladies and gentlemen, on World Championship Wrestling. Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer and Tommy Wildfire Rich coming up in just a moment. Here with Kevin Sullivan, the Boston Battlers. Ask for some time.
I certainly have. You know, Mr. Ross, strange things are starting to happen, aren't they? It's like an ill wind has blown back in the NWA. Friends have turned against friends. I hear Dr. Death now trying to reach out and snatch something from Lex Luger. I see all shapes and forms coming. And I see madness. I see madness, and I see a box of madness ready to be opened. Jim Ross, there is madness in the whole universe. All that has to be done is sometimes hinged and sent to the right direction. You know, I've been looking around, and I have seen a man who can be controlled, a man that can be brought to destiny, and I know one thing. Dogs do fly.
He's sick. He's sick. Fans, let's go up to Rhubarb.
Ladies and gentlemen, in your next event, introducing first, from Sacramento, California, Buzz Sawyer.
It's Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
And introducing his opponent, making his way into the ring area, from Atlanta, Georgia, Wild Buzz Tommy Rich.
And ladies and gentlemen, Tommy Wildfire Rich and Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. It all started right here on TBS between those two, but I am intrigued by what Kevin Sullivan had to say. He's got something on his mind, apparently some sort of surprise here next week on the program. As if we needed more excitement here, we're going to have a great program here next week.
Brother, next week's going to be cooking, and the only thing that I understood...
Oh, he went for the post. Oh,
the only thing that I understood is when Kevin Sullivan said, dogs do fly. That's exactly what Buzz Sawyer said. An allegiance of any kind between Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer and Kevin Sullivan, that would be too much.
Well, you don't think that's going to happen, do you?
Hey, you never know, Jim. You never know what would happen.
Sawyer takes Tommy Rich down by the hair. Fans, we got a big week ahead of us here. Of course, tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock, the big one in Knoxville. That's a 3 o'clock start in the afternoon, Tennessee Street Fight, Norman and Kevin Sullivan. Want to say hi to the fans in Rainesville, Alabama, throughout that great area. This Monday night, 7:30 in the Rainesville, Alabama Civic Center, national television taping, over 30 stars in Rainesville. Good arm drag takeover by Tommy Wildfire Rich.
Why would he make that comment? Dogs do fly.
I don't know.
I would say stranger things have happened, but there wouldn't have been anything stranger than what happened. Had an allegiance between those two guys.
The Stinger and Lex Luger have signed to appear on the big card this Tuesday night in Gainesville. Road Warriors and Skyscrapers will be in Albany, Georgia this Wednesday night at the Civic Center, 7:30. World Tag Team Championship will be decided in Augusta, Thursday night at 7:30. Great week. That's Monday in Rainesville, Alabama, Tuesday in Gainesville, Wednesday in Albany, Thursday in Augusta, this Friday night in Carbondale at the SIU Arena. And, of course, 1 week from tonight in Jackson, Tennessee at the Omen Arena. That's formerly the Civic Center.
Yeah, let's talk about Tennessee and Jackson, Tennessee. You're going to see the Freebirds and Flying Brown and Z-Man. And the Midnight Express and the Rock and Roll Express are going to be there, too. And next Sunday in Murfreesboro, first time ever in the Murphy Center. Brother, the Road Warriors, Dr. Death, everybody, 7:30, right down there in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Look at Tommy Rich and Buzz Sawyer. It's like the last 6 years never happened. It's been 6 years since the last Battle of Atlanta. These two guys waged one of the most bitter and bloody feuds ever in professional wrestling. 6 years ago, they had their final match, the last Battle of Atlanta. Now it's happening all over again.
Tommy Rich been busted in the mouth there by Buzz Sawyer's right hand, but Tommy holds on. Man, he is tenacious.
I would venture to say that these guys at one time wrestle each other every night for 2 years, and neither one of them ever gained a clear-cut advantage.
Very evenly matched are these two gentlemen. Well, one gentleman, oh, flying forearm. What? Tommy Rich may have the lights put out right here. Oh, Pee Wee Anderson came down for 2.5.
The thing that made this match so intriguing and so exciting.
Inside cradle. He can hold him down here. 1, 2, and he kicked
it. He almost had him. Buzz Sawyer obviously has superior physical ability. He's bigger and he's stronger than Tommy Rich. But Tommy Rich always had that fighting heart. He's always had those guts. He would never give up, even when he was beat half to death. And that's what made this match both so interesting and so violent.
Fans, don't forget the NWA main event tomorrow night back at its normal time, 6:05 Eastern time. I'll be joined by Missy Hyatt, and we will have the Road Warriors and Dr. Death taking on the Samoan Savage and the Wild Samoans. Michael Hayes and I will do the play-by-play for that particular event. Big program tomorrow, 6:05 here on TBS. He's got him. One, two.
He almost had him in that backslide. Referee Pee Wee Anderson, he had made the two count. Buzz Sawyer's shoulder came up right at the two. Pee Wee almost hesitated, but finally got that two count.
Sawyer forcing Tommy Rich back into the corner. Fans, remember, Arn Anderson defends the TV title here next week against Shane Douglas. Good Lord. Come on, ref. Break, disqualify. That's what I would do. Period.
That's because you're squeamish, Jim. That's why you do that. When you get in the ring with the Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer, you got to expect violence. Tommy Rich has been there many, many times. He knows what to expect, but he gives back the same thing, violence.
Tommy Rich to the elbow right off the second rope, back into the arm bar, controlling Buzz Sawyer. He knows he's got to keep the buzzer away from that momentum, keep him at bay, if that is possible.
Only in the NWA would you find rivalry so heated, Jim. After 6 years, they said, Tommy Rich, you want to get back in the ring with Buzz Sawyer? He said, you're dead gum right I do. After 2 years, after a five-year-long battle, they asked the Rock and Roll Express and the Midnight Express, you want to get back in the ring? And they all said, sure we do. Because these guys have rivalries that go far beyond the bounds of the wrestling ring.
I found the most interesting what Sting had to say just a little bit earlier in the program. His momentum has not been deterred. His confidence has not been lessened. And that just makes WrestleWar 90 the biggest wrestling event ever, because Sting has that motivation. He has promised to win the World's Championship for the fans on that occasion. Be sure that you call your local cable company and make plans on seeing that live as it happens February 25th in Greensboro. Sunset flip right there. Lateral press, he got two. Or a sunset press. And a hard drag takeover. Buzz Sawyer back down to the canvas.
I'll tell you what, Sting has made a tall promise. He's saying he's going to win the World Heavyweight Championship because he knows how to hurt Ric Flair, take his title away. The Horseman hurt Sting by hurting his pride, so he wants to hurt Flair by taking his most precious possession away. Pretty tall order.
It certainly is, but it would certainly be the cure for what happened to Sting at the Clash of Champions if he walks away from Greensboro as the new World's Heavyweight Champion.
Could we be seeing another rivalry that will last for years, like the Sawyers, the Riches, the Midnights, and Rock and Rolls in Flair and Sting? Or do you think, Jim, that one explosive confrontation like February 25th will tell the tale by giving one guy the confidence that he can always come out on top? What do you think?
I think what you're looking at here is a situation where it could very easily be a one-match situation. If Flair, oh, look at that. If Flair retains the title, he's not going to want to wrestle Sting again.
And by the same token, if Sting was able to beat Ric Flair and win the title, he better not give him a rematch, because you don't beat Ric Flair that often.
Well, he did it at Starrcade in the finals of the Iron Man tournament.
Flair had already wrestled Lex Luger and the Great Muta.
So had Sting. So had Sting. Remember that?
Don't confuse the issue with facts, Jim.
Tommy Rich with a big elbow. Down goes Buzz Sawyer. Boy, this is a competitive situation. I hate to use the word hatred, but these two guys have a total disdain for each other and have had for a long time.
Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer hates almost everybody. He despises Tommy Wildfire Rich.
Sawyer with that suplex.
Rich, brother, they've been going at it.
Yes, he has. It has been very, very physical here. And Sawyer, who has really been punished, going up very slowly to the top.
He's in a daze. He doesn't know what's going on half the time anyway.
He with a Peter Boyle haircut. This will be all if he hits it.
The dog's going to fly.
But nobody's home. Tommy Rich back up to his feet. But Sawyer's got him in that power slam.
He got the drugs.
And he got a pin. He stole it.
I love it.